A starting point to the study of linear algebra are systems of linear equations. And here is how a generic system of such equations will look like. Here these a's and b's, these are the coefficients of the system, which are some constant real numbers. And by the way, this thickened R will always denote the set of all real numbers. So these are the coefficients, and then these x1, x2, and so on, these are the variables of the system. Now, more concretely, here we have a couple of examples of systems of linear equations. And this first one, this is a system of two equations in two variables. And the other one is a system of, again, two equations, but in three variables. Now, before we get any farther, I should say here that from the practical perspective, both of these are examples of very small systems of linear equations. And that's because in many applications of linear algebra in physics, computer science, engineering, economics, and so on, people deal with systems of linear equations which may involve hundreds, thousands, sometimes millions of variables and equations. So again, a thing to keep in mind is that systems of linear equations appearing in practical applications can be very large. Now, if we are given a system of linear equations, and regardless if this is a small or very large system, then the most obvious question is, what are the solutions of this system? And now a very nice thing is that there is a simple and relatively fast method of solving systems of linear equations, and that this is a method that works in all cases, which means regardless how many variables and how many equations are involved. So later on I will explain how this method works, so I will explain how we can solve an arbitrary system of linear equations in some systematic way. But before we get there, it will be good to have a look first how solutions of systems of linear equations may look like. And so my immediate goal will be to explain here first of all how many solutions of a system of linear equations we can have. And also, and as you will see, this is a related topic, I will explain how we can interpret systems of equations and their solutions geometrically. So, we will start by looking at some examples of systems of linear equations, and we will start small by looking at systems of just two variables. And here we have one such system. This is a system of two equations in two variables. And now I have mentioned before that we have those general methods that tell us how to solve systems of linear equations of any size. But if we are dealing with a system of equations as small as this one here, then we can actually solve it easily without using any special methods. And in the case of this particular system, if we want to solve it, then we can start, say, by adding these two equations side by side. And then we have x1 in the first equation, we add it to x1 from the second equation, and this gives us 2x1. Next, we have positive x2 in the first equation, which will cancel with the negative x2 from the second equation. So that will give us 0x2. And then finally, on the other side of the equality signs, we have 1 and 1. And these added together give us 2. So, altogether we obtain 2x1 plus 0x2 equals to 2. And this shows, of course, that x1 has to be equal to 1. Now, since we know the value of x1, we can plug it into, say, the first equation in the system. And then this equation becomes 1 plus x2 equals to 1. Which of course means that x2 must be equal to 0. So now we have these two numbers, x1 equal to 1, x2 equal to 0. And as you can check, these numbers satisfy both equations in our system. So these numbers give us a solution of the system of equations. Actually, from the computations I made here, you can see more. Namely, you can see that these two numbers give us the only possible solution of the system of equations. And that's because in the process of solving these equations, we were forced to make x1 equal to 1 and x2 equal to 0. We had no other options. So, as it turns out, this system here is a system of equations that has exactly one solution. Now, I have mentioned before that systems of linear equations can be interpreted geometrically, and for systems of equations in two variables, this geometrical interpretation is actually very simple. The basic idea is that if we have a single linear equation in two variables, not a system of equations, but just a single equation, then such equation has a graph, and this graph is some line on the plane. And, for example, the graph of the first equation in this our system here is this line, and the graph of the second equation is this line over here. Next, as you can see, these two lines intersect at this single point, and then we can ask, what is the meaning of this point of intersection? And this is not hard to explain, because, you see, points that belong to this first line, these are precisely the points whose coordinates satisfy the first equation, and the points that belong to the second line, these are the points whose coordinates satisfy the second equation. Now, this point of intersection, this is the point that belongs to both the first and the second line, which means that its coordinates must satisfy both the first and the second equation of the system. In other words, this means that coordinates of this point of intersection are precisely the numbers which give us the solution of this system of equations. So, what we obtained here is a geometric picture of the system of equations. There is one line in this picture for each equation in the system, and then the intersection point of these lines correspond to the solution of the system. In this case, we have a system with only one solution, and now we can see it in this picture, since these two lines have only one point of intersection. It is not true, though, that every system of linear equations will look like this one here. That is, it is not true that we will always have exactly one solution. And to see what else may happen, let's have a look at a different example. So, here we have again a system of two equations in two variables. But in this case, even without doing any computations, you can notice that this system cannot possibly have any solutions. And this happens because the first equation in this system is x1 plus x2 equals to 1, and the second equation is almost identical. It is x1 plus x2 equals to 2. Now, if this system would have a solution, then that would mean that we could find numbers, x1 and x2, that added together would give us 1 to satisfy the first equation, and then the very same two numbers added together would have to give us 2 to satisfy the second equation. And this is, of course, a contradiction. This cannot happen. So again, this here is a system of equations that has no solutions. Now, just as we did before, we can have a look at the geometric picture of this system. And since, again, this is a system of two equations, this picture will consist of two lines. But in this case, as you can see, these lines, which are graphs of these two equations, are parallel lines. And well, this is not unexpected, because as we have seen in this previous example, intersection points of these lines would correspond to solutions of the system of equations. Since this system has no solutions, we can't have any points of intersection. And then if we have non-intersecting lines on a plane, then such lines must be parallel lines. Here we have one more example. And again, this is a system of two equations in two variables. But what is special about this system is that, as you can see, the second equation is just obtained by multiplying the first equation by 2. Now, from the perspective of finding solutions of the system, this means that the second equation doesn't give us any additional information about the solutions in addition to what we will know from the first equation. And that's because if we find numbers x1 and x2 which satisfy the first equation, then such numbers will automatically satisfy the second equation. So, when we are solving this system, we can simply forget about the second equation and we can just simply deal with the first one. And now, what about this first equation? Well, we can say solve it for x1, and that will give us that x1 equals to 1 minus x2. So this tells us what is x1, provided, of course, that we know what is the value of x2. Here is the thing, though. This first equation, and so this whole system of equations, does not give us any constraints on this value of x2. If we set x2 to be any number, and then if we make x1 to be 1 minus that number, then we will get values of x1 and x2 that will satisfy the system of equations. And this is actually how we can describe solutions of the system. x1 must be equal to 1 minus x2, but then x2 can be any number. It can have any value. What this means, of course, is that this system of equations is a system that has an infinite number of solutions, since we will have one solution for each value of x2, and then there is infinite number of choices for that value. So again, this here is a system with an infinite number of solutions. Now, we can look at the geometry behind this system. And in this case, since these two equations that make up this system are multiples of each other, the graph of the first equation and the graph of the second equation will be actually given by the very same line. So the geometric picture of the system are these two overlapping lines. This, of course, coincides with the fact that we have here a system of equations with infinitely many solutions. Each solution of the system corresponds to one point of intersection of these lines, so these lines have to intersect in infinitely many points, and if lines intersect in more than one point, then such lines must overlap.